Wow. Okay, that works really well. About a year ago, I shared a video with amazing technology that removes reflections from the glass in photographs.
Let's also save the reflection. Reflections are gone.
People have asked me, when's that coming to Photoshop? Wait no longer, it's here, but it's hidden, and let me show you how to get access. So first of all, you want to launch Photoshop. Just the regular version of Photoshop is fine, and you want to get to Camera Raw. So either open a RAW file or just create a new document and go into Camera Raw. However you want to do it, I just created a new document, and then we choose Filter, Camera Raw Filter. We just want to get in here and then hit this gear. Now, when you go on the gear, choose Technology Previews and turn on New AI Features and Settings Panel. Click OK. Restart Photoshop so it takes effect. So we're just going to choose File, Open, and you want to make sure that you grab RAW files. So I'm going to grab these two, and I'm going to show you kind of where it works and where it doesn't. So here's a picture I took of a picture with all the reflections that you would expect from that. So let's have a look here. We're going to grab the eraser tool and we're going to go down to reflections. Now watch what happens. Wow. Okay, that works really well. So if we look at this, we've got most of the reflections removed. Let me show you before and after. You can see it's done a good job, but we've got some of these specular highlights. This is an area it struggles with. So if we look at this shot here where I don't have the specular highlight and then I turn on reflection removal, and you can see there, it does a really good job of this picture of a younger me a few years ago when I did this collaboration with NVIDIA. So when we go to the one that does have the highlights, this is something Adobe says they're working on. Of course, we can get rid of it by using the generative remove in here. If we just go in here, grab that, and we can just mark these areas. And we can just choose remove. So it's easy enough to fix those, but let's look at another example. Here's a shot you can see as a sheet of glass between me and this train, and you can see the reflections in there. But also you can see there's glare, which takes away a lot of clarity in this image. So what we're going to do is go to the tools, and we're going to grab the remove tool. When we're in the remove tool, we can go down and we see an option here that says reflections. So we're going to turn on reflections, and now it's going to analyze this image and apply it. And look at how amazing that is. If we look at this before and after, you can see it completely removes all those reflections and adds all that punch in there. Let's have a look at a setting. So if we look at reflections, right now it's set to 100. If I take this down to 0, you'll notice that the reflections start to come back. And then when we get to 0, that's our original image. There's our before, after, you can see it's exactly the same. But now as we reduce it more, now we start to get rid of the image and just show the reflections. So we can see here's a reflection at minus 100, here's the image at 100. As an added bonus, you could grab this reflection in Photoshop and apply it to another image to add reflections if you wanted. Okay, so the way this works is it uses AI, but it does not use generative AI. So what Adobe's done is it's trained it on a bunch of images that they have intentionally superimposed two images together. So what happens is it learns to see this is what the reflection is and this is what the image looks like, and it separates the two. So currently it only works on things like plate glass. It doesn't work on things like glasses and different things like that. Adobe says they are working on it. So for things like glass, reflections on pictures, it's working really, really well. So currently right now, it's only in the Camera Raw, it only works on RAW, but Adobe have said that they're working on supporting other formats such as JPEG, PNG, and they are also working at getting this into Lightroom pretty soon. So I'm going to keep you posted as this feature develops and keep you abreast of all the new features and stuff. So I'm personally very excited about this because it's the kind of thing you can use when you're shooting through airplane windows or when you're driving along in your car and you're shooting through the window of a car, you know, something passing by and you get those reflections. It's going to make it easy to remove them. Okay, so there's a link here to the original video I did with the reflection removal from the sneaks. Let me know in the comments underneath what you think about this emerging new technology. And if you're new to the cafe, hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.